Okay. So walang sa tiyaga, walang nilaga. So these are common errors that still persist in quiz 4. So these are the following, not following instructions. So it's basic kasi napakadali na nito. Pag sinabing numeral only, susulat nyo lang po yung numeral. No space, no maru or period kasi you're not creating sentence. Okay? So follow the instruction. Actually may mga students tayo nagkamali pa, no, parang may mga kama-kama or may mga kama pa silang ginamit eh. Wala namang tayong kama or period or maru, no. So please follow the instruction kasi as much as possible the exam is automated. So we don't want to to override the system as frequent as possible. Parang sa industry lang yan, diba? So when you are issuing ticket, it's automated. You don't want to call your supervisor or manager most of the time. Now, if you're in the hotel business, the system is automated. Whenever the client book or place a booking in the internet or in Expedia, it's being reflected in our CRS. So we don't call our supervisor or manager again from time to time to, you know, override the system. So we don't want that. Okay? So strictly follow the instruction. Next. Lack of prolonged vowels. Wrong usage of small cases and large cases. And Dochira versus Doko, Dare and versus Dore. So these are the common mistakes or errors that they are or the students are committing during the exam. So for not following instruction, it can help you much. You have to read, you have to understand it. And it's quite fatal, you know, when you take the comprehensive examination, when you take civil service examination, you take the Japanese proficiency examination, you cannot ask for assistance or reconsideration, no? Kasi bayad ka ulit. Ganun lang naman kasimple siya eh, diba? So for this exam, you have to be very careful. Okay. Next. So lack of prolonged vowels. So for example, itong si Miss, okay, I have one student nag-ask siya. Also sa mga words po na double U, nakalagay or U, yung dash or yung double U, yung iba po single lang nakalagay ko kasi I thought acceptable din po siya. Okay. Now, of course, hindi siya acceptable. Why? Because the U corresponds to an additional kana. Okay, it's a prolonged kana. So, gaano ba ka-importante yung prolonged kana na yan? It's important because when you write kanji, okay, so of course you write kanji using the hiragana keyboards, no? So, when you write kanji using these keyboards, when the keyboard reads it as U, single U, and by the way, there's no U, there's U, no? Single U. So, it's creating a character of Yuki. Now, if it's written as Yuki, which is a prolonged U. There is an U. It means courage. So madaling, malaki implication niya. So as early as now, we want you or I want you to become more conscious of this nuisance in writing. No? So dapat conscious po tayo. Para pagdating po natin sa next level, hindi tayo hirap. Okay, next. Another issue po is, okay, is the use of the 10, no? Sa 10 kasi nakalagay toka. Okay, yoka. Okay. So when you write yoka, you just add u or yung u natin. Pero kay toka kasi when I create a blog or lecture, it's toka, as in diretsong to, no. So this one is katulad siya ng otosan, hindi siya prolong using u. It's prolong using the word or the vowel o. So toka, which is double o. Okay, T-O-O-K-A. And by the way, we don't spell it in that kind of format because we're again, should be thinking like Japanese. Kasi yung context natin, we are thinking using English, no? Letters, no? And by the way, there's no letters in Japanese. We have kana. So there are two kanas lang, to at o. Okay, that's the two kanas, no? In English, that's T-O-O. Okay. Now, of course, without checking it out, you might be committing an error of putting U in U. Okay? So, yung po, careful po tayo. And by the way, One of the ako personal na hirapan din ako sa Romaji because Romaji is tricky and quite limited in expressing oneself in Japanese. And by the way, in Japan, there are different system of Romaji or Romanization. So I think there is four or if I'm mistaken, it's a six system, different systems that you can use. So medyo talagang tricky siya, no? So and sa Japan, hindi naman talaga ginagamit ang romanization, Romaji, besides writing your name in your passport and other important government forms na something to do with international. Kasi, yun nga, number one, magulo siya. And of course, it doesn't really capture the Japanese, no? Okay. So of course, sa Japan, ang gamit lang is hiragana, katakana, at kanji. Okay, yun lang naman yung preferred system nila. Now, of course, we cannot avoid using Romaji because ang point of reference natin is from English or Filipino, which is letter-based, alphabet-based, going to kana or character-based. No? So, of course, it's really inbuilt to us. Now, if we're going to use it, we prefer to use the word processor method. So, yung parang kung ano yung ginagamit natin sa pagta-type natin sa keyboard, yun ang gagamitin natin para mas madali natin siyang maalala at para mas madali natin siyang isulat. Practical lang. And of course, as much as possible, since we're going to foreign language too, it's much more prefer if you could memorize or prefer to store the information or the vocabulary using kana or kanji. Kasi nga, this will be very handy in the future kasi mas madali yung recall. Okay? So yun siya. Next. Wrong usage of small case and large case. Again, marami po pa rin nagkakamali. So when you're creating kya from kaya, 'di ba? Kaya or kya, we use a small case, no? So importante po 'yan. So for this character there are the small case and large case, no? So may iba po yung student na nag-imbento pa ng ibang small case. That is the case of hiragana, which is hindi natin ginagamit. Okay, hindi pa natin siya ginagamit right now or hindi natin gagamitin kasi we're not going to write using hiragana. Okay, so please go back to our prior lessons or prior video lectures for small case and large case hiragana, how to write it properly. Okay, next. Oh, ito yung sample, no? Sample mistake niya. So, tama naman siya, kaso lang, the problem is how he writes the character ya or kana ya. So, naging ano siya, no? Bayaku instead of byaku, which is, of course, mali na siya. Malaking difference niyan. Okay? Okay, next naman is ito rin. So ganun din, may mali rin siya, no? Instead na writing of ng jupun with double P in our English or alphabet type of thinking, nasulat niya is jupun lang, kulang siya ng letter P or kulang siya ng small su. Okay, so yun po, no? So dito makikita nyo talaga, syempre mali na talaga yan, X na siya. Wala tayong magagawa dyan, that's the rule. Next, okay. May isang ko student nagtanong, ilong-hilo siya doon sa 10 actually. Of course, kanya-kanya naman tayo ng ano, no, the way of comprehending it. So ako, nag-aaral ako, hindi ako naguluhan dito, pero of course, syempre, kanya-kanya nga ng way of absorption. Okay. So writing 10. So writing 10 is 10 is expressed as ju, as in J Y U U, or ju, as in J-U-U. Okay. Or ju, as in J-U, tapos may prolong or may dash sa taas. Which is, of course, it means to say jo, jo. Kasi the pronunciation is jo, J-O-O. Ju, diba? Ju or jo, for pronunciation purposes. Nga, syempre, ju tayo dyan. Ju, diba? So, syempre, ang sounds niya more of parang they're trying to mimic the sound of the ju. Okay. So again, dito naman papasok po yung, 'di ba, pag romanization medyo different system, no. Meron tayong word processing system, national system, Hertzsprung system. So medyo ang kasi ang ano kasi ng Romagin or Roman letters is they're trying to capture the way it being pronounced, not the way it should be correctly written in Hiragana. Okay, so yun ang difference, no? So kaya may mga ganyang variations. These are aids on how to properly pronounce the Japanese words in nearer or nearest to the sounds of how the Japanese speaks or how the Japanese pronounces word. It's not really intended for writing purposes. Secondary lang yung writing. So medyo mahirap magsulat if you're reliant on the Romaji. And by the way, there are ways of learning Japanese without using Romaji. So I already sinubukan din natin siya. No? Kaso lang, syempre, we are, dahil Pilipino tayo, we are used for English and Tagalog. And most textbooks are using Romaji as a bridge. So, syempre, mas madali sa atin to introduce Japanese using Romaji. Pero if you are Chinese or you are Korean, diretso na sila sa Hiragana. They don't introduce using Romaji. So tayo kasi, or among Westerns, no, English, tapos Romaji, and then yung Hiragana, Katakana, and Kanji. No? So ganun yung system natin. Kasi from one system, tatalon tayo, tapos may bridging, parang bridging natin is Romaji. Now for Chinese, di na nila kailangan yung diretso na sa the way they write it in Japanese. So, yun ang ating ano. Anyway, that's my observation lang. It's not really, kasi hindi naman ako nagturo ng Japanese sa Chinese, no? So, that's how I see things around. Pero, case to case pa rin. Okay, anyway, so 10 is written as Ju, no? So, paano ba isusulat ang Ju? And of course, 10 is different from the it's different when used in different counters. Kasi may student tayo nagtanong, sir, di ba akala ko ba yung Jew is ano? Jew is Jew as in double U lang siya. Bakit pag dinuktong siya sa minutes, nagiging Jupun, di ba? Of course, syempre, may ganong. Pag counters kasi, they add something no at the end. So nagkakaroon tayo ng small Su, which is PTKS siya. So, and finally, there is a student of mine na nagtanong, sir, kala ko ba 10 is Ju, which is correct. 10 is Ju, pero hindi siya Toka. Toka, di ba? 10 kasi 10th day, di ba? Toka. So, 10 is not equivalent of 10th, di ba? Iba yung 10 sa 10th. Okay. Yung sa 10 kasi binibilang mo yung numbers lang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, di ba? So, 10. Yung sa 10th, binibilang mo yung order niya. Pang ilan siya? Pang 10, di ba? Hindi ka nagbibilang ng quantity, nagbibilang ka ng order. Okay. So, let's have some example. So, anuin ko lang to, ha? Okay. Dito na ako sa Texilogos. So, there are two ways of how to write sa Texilogos. You can input it directly using your keyboard. So, pwede tayo, let's say, Ju, di ba? So, normally, pagta-type natin ng Ju, ganito lang siya. So, automatic na siyang magta-type. Now, if we're attempting to use Ju na J-Y-U-U, medyo disaster ka dyan because the J will automatically read. Okay, so avoid niya siya. Mas madali ang proseso ng J-U-U. Diba? J-U-U-U. Or Ju, which is prolonged. Now, if you're writing yung Jupun, pag nakalimutan niyo po may extra P siya, mali kayo. Diba? Katulad niya, mali siya. So, how to write it? You write it as, diba? Ju, tapos small su. So, nakikita niyo tong keyboard na to. Okay, yan, gamitin niyo. Okay, nandiyan dyan siya, gamitin siya. And then, write, pun. Yan. So, pag tinipe niyo kasi diretso siya, tignan niyo, may letter P, diba? So, nagkakamali kayo. And syempre, dahil parang gusto nyo, but may letter P? So, tatanggalin nyo na lang, tapos i-copy-paste nyo na lang. Yun na magiging sagot nyo, which is mamamali kayo. Okay? So, tingin ko kadalasan kaya nagkakamali mga student because of that. And you have to be careful kasi wala tayong consideration for that. That's part of our exam. Okay? Okay. So, going back. So, sorry. Sorry for that. Okay. So now we have, okay, another example na madalas tayong magkamali or madalas nagkakamali ang mga estudyante is the use of docera, doko, dare, or dore. Bakit? Kasi yung docera, marami siyang gamit. Pwede siya maging place, pwede siya maging or where, pwede siya maging which, di ba, for things. Or pwede rin siya maging who, para sa tao. However, you have to understand that the docera is easy, madali naman mag-get siya because kung babasahin nyo po yung context or babasahin yung conversation nyo or of course, papapalagay nyo yung sarili nyo sa context ng taong nagsasalita nun. Okay? So, mas madali natin siya maintindihan pag ganun. Ngayon kung parang ano lang, magbabasa ka lang, hindi natin masyadong pinag... Hello? So, yun lang, no? So, basta you have to use your... you have to put yourself to the context nung nagsasalita. And of course, docera could be... confusing at first, pero when you get the thought, the context of the conversation, makukuha nyo na. Okay, example. Ito, no? Okada-san wa docera desu ka? So, of course, alam natin si Okada is tao or name of a person because may san. Tapos, alam natin yung wa dyan or ha as the particle, no? Which marks the subject. And of course, docera, ano ba siya? Where, who, or which. Tignan natin. Yung sagot ng person to is, socera des. So basically, pwede naman yung tanongin na sino ba si Okada-san? Pero, syempre, parang it does not make sense. No? Parang siguro kasi, i-assume nyo na si person 1, parang, kilala, kumbaga sa ano, syempre, hindi naman niya tatanungin or hindi niya sasabihin yung pangalan ng tao kung number one, hindi niya kilala kung sino yun. So, meron na kayong point of reference siguro na o may idea kayo kung sino siya, di ba? So, parang kung dare or who, parang hindi naman. Dore or which, pwede. Maaring magkatabi, may dalawang tao magkatabi or may isang tao malapit sa kausap mo, may isang tao malapit sa iyo. Tignan mo kung sino ba dito si Okada-san. Pwede yon, no? Pwede. Or most probably, ang guess natin dito is docera, kung nasaan siya. Because I think that will be more applicable kahit sabi mo which siya. Kasi nga, syempre, place pa rin. Anyway, so that is for the first conversation. Second conversation is sumimasen. Docera-san desu ka? The answer of the person 2 is Argel desu. Okay. So, ito, obvious na siya. Na, who? Okay, bakit? Kasi may san eh. Number one, may san siya. At number two, wala siyang prior name. So, meaning to say, kumbaga sa ano yung taong person one is, siguro, baka wala pa siya. Hindi niya kilala kung sino yung kausap niya or hindi niya kilala kung sino yung tao na nirefer niya. So, basically, it could mean dare or who. No? So, ganun siya. You have to put yourself to the context nung statement or yung conversation para makita niyo yung flow. Okay? So, yun lang. Practice lang. Okay? Next. Okay. Refer naman tayo sa test niyo mismo. So, test natin sa final exam. So, again, the final exam is 20% of your grade. So, it's important. And of course, in-expect ko na hindi tayo gagawa ng something that could be threatening our academic integrity, no? So, huwag tayong ganun. And also, pag may sagot kayo, huwag nyo na i-share siya sa mga classmate nyo, ha? Para hindi tayo, alam nyo na, honest tayo. Okay. Tandaan ng karma yung online na. Okay? Tandaan. Now, writing, the structure or the test is basically composed for these two purposes, no? Ito yung pinaka-reason niya. Number one is to test your writing skills, no? So, particularly writing hiragana using online keyboard. So, wala tayong katakana, wala tayong romaji, puro hiragana. Kasi transition na tayo. So, pag next sem na, puro hiragana, katakana, kanji na. So, of course, syempre para yung mind ninyo mukhang ano na, ga-adapt-adapt na. Okay? Next is, yung multiple choices natin, ito medyo mapapaisip talaga kayo. Kaya malaki po yung points niya, no? Kasi dito, itetest ko yung knowledge nyo for writing accuracy, madetermine nyo kung alin dyan yung tama at mali using proper hiragana rules, diba? Bukod sa pag pinasulat ko kayo, dito, i-determine nyo kung tama yung sinulat ko, di ba? Next is yung grammar correctness. Kung naiintindihan yung grammar, yung context ng grammar. So, importante alam nyo yung ating mga sentence pattern. From lesson 1, 2, 3, 4, yung sa 4 natin, or, yung mga ano natin, di ba? Yung mga vocabularies, kasi vocabulary pa lang sa lesson 4, pamatay na. Pero don't worry, binabagalan naman natin. So, pagdating natin sa next time, lesson 4 pa rin tayo, pero more of additional vocabulary sa grammar parts na. So, medyo mahirap siya, pero kayang-kaya naman kasi nag-survive na tayo. Next is functional, cultural, and contextual use nung ating convo or usapan or mga words na yun. Okay, so go na tayo. Okay, so writing accuracy. So if you remember sa quiz 3 dati, may tanong tayong ganyan, no? So determine nyo kung tama yung sinulat. Okay, so basically, I have two statement here. So if you examine, mukha siyang tama pero mali siya. Bakit? Bakit nagkamali? Eh, kasi tignan niyo to, 'di ba? Okay. So ano to, 'di ba? So first mukha siyang tama pero mali siya. Bakit? Kasi 'di ba when we write particle wa, we write it using ha, not wa. Okay, remember particle ha tayo, not particle or not hiragana or kana wa. Okay, so yun na po yung mistake niya. So basically, alam niyo na sagutin niyo, both statement are incorrect. Okay. So that is choice B. Okay. Diba? Kasi apat ang choice niya. Statement are both correct, statement are both incorrect, statement A or statement 1 is correct while statement 2 is not. Statement or D, statement 1 is incorrect while statement 2 is correct. So, 4 choices kayo. Dito mapapaisip talaga kayo. Okay? So, ingat po tayo dyan. So, the first question or some question would test your writing accuracy. Hindi naman niya sasabihin na, oh, itong question na to for writing accuracy, yung question na to for grammar, question na to for contextual. So, i-determine nyo nga using the three objectives na yan. Okay? Kung alin dyan yung contextual, alin dyan yung writing, alin dyan yung grammar. So, madi-determine nyo naman if you read the lines. Okay, next. Grammar correctness. First statement is, okada-san no nihonjin desu. Okay. Statement 2. Okada-san wa sensei desu. Okay, parang... Okay, so may idea na ba kayo kung ano yung tama or ano yung san or tama ba yung statement natin or may mali? Okay, if kung kutob nyo, parang something is off sa statement 1, tama kayo because instead of particle no, I think it should be particle wa. Bakit? Kasi dito okada-san no nihonjin desu. Ah. Okada or Japanese that are okadas. Diba? Parang wrong. Diba? It should be wa. Because siguro yung statement na to, so pangat na sulat ko. Wait lang. Ha? Wrong. Ulitin natin. Okay. Sorry ha. Yan. So it should be wa. Bakit wa? Mas may sense kasi pag sinabi mo okada-san wa nihonjin desu. Okada is a Japanese. Rather than saying Japanese are okadas. Kasi di ba pag nag-translate, when you use particle no, it's baliktad sa English, no? So baliktad siya. For example, Nihonjin no gakusei, Japanese student, di ba? Or student from Japan. So nababaliktad siya sa English. So ang pinaka-importante, nauuna. So syempre, mas importante yung characteristic mo rather than si okada mismo, di ba? Kasi nga, yun ang magde-define sa'yo, pagiging nihonjin mo rather than pagiging okada-san mo, di ba? So parang off yung statement 1. Statement 2, tama naman. Okada-san wa sensei desu. Kasi dinidefine siya nung pagiging sensei kung sino si okada. So it makes sense, di ba? So you have the subject and the predicate. So for statement 1, which is off because your predicate is more or parang subject mo and yung predicate mo parang hindi siya ganun kalinaw, no? Because of the particle. Okay, so yun po. So the answer would be, okay, D. Statement 1 is incorrect while statement 2 is correct. Okay, ganun-ganun lang naman siya. So, syempre, practice kayo, aral-aral tayo, ha? Saka, mahaba na may oras ninyo para mag-analyze. You have 1 hour and 30 minutes to do it. And you have just, ilang questions ba kayo? 25 questions, no? Or 25 items siya. So, the first exam would be 3 points each item. And the second exam would be 4 points each item. So, mahaba yung time nyo. Okay? Mag-analyze. Pero again, sa totoong buhay, dapat hindi ganun katagal kayo ha, kasi exam to eh. Okay? Next. Ito na. Functional and cultural and contextual usage. Yan. So, i-check nyo kung makatotohanan ba to. Tama ba sa pagkakagamit sa tunay na buhay in reference to the Japanese language. Sa cultural context, syempre, na-explain ko naman yan, di ba? Most likely, mga greetings yan. Yung functional natin, tama ba yung application yan sa tunay na buhay, di ba? Yung pagkakagamit natin, di ba? Okay. So, let's practice. At the office and leaving the workplace. So, another tip, pag ganito yung tanungan, makakita na kayo na parang setting. May setting na siya, di ba? Parang binibigyan kayo ng idea kung nasan sila. Kasi, syempre, contextual siya. So, saka functional. Importante rin may setting ka, no? So, tignan natin. At the office and leaving the workplace. So, may aalis, nasa office sila. Okay. Person A. Osaki ni. Osaki ni. Otsukaresama deshita. So, syempre, kailan ba sinasabi yung Otsukaresama deshita? Syempre, di ba pag nag-aral tayo or nagdi-discuss, sinasabi nyo to at the end of the class. So, thank you very much for teaching us today. Or, it's normally said sa office place or sa workplace pag aalis ka na and thanking for the effort of your kasama. O sa akin ni, I go ahead yan. Okay, I go ahead. Okay. So sa person B, sayonara. Okay, sayonara. So, yun ang sagot niya. Okay, question, tama ba? Okay. At first glance, tama naman sir kasi wala naman typo. Number one, tama yung hiragana. Number two, mukhang tama naman kasi wala naman problema sa grammar. Mukhang naman okay sila. Yun. Kaso lang, ang problema dyan, hindi naman grammar, no? It's more of functional and context. Bakit? Ang problema dyan, eto. Sayonara. Bakit? Kasi di ba pag sinabi mo sayonara, farewell ka. So, farewell. Ano yan? Hindi na magre-resign na ba yan? Hindi na babalik. So, wala naman siyang sinabi magre-resign siya. So, hindi mo sasabihin yan, di ba? Sayonara, di ba? Normally, hindi natin sinasabi yan. Diba? Pag nagsalita ka na sayonara, again, lecture, lesson natin sa basic greetings, no? Yung ating 24 words that you must remember in Japanese is that ang sayonara ginagamit natin to imply na you're going to leave the premise or you're going to leave the office for a very long time. Either magre-resign ka, magre-retire, or meron kang sick leave or mag-leave ka. So, sayonara yon. Now, so for that sense, mali yung sinasabi ni person B. So, maaari natin sabihin that letter D tayo. Person A statement is correct while person B statement is incorrect. Okay. Incorrect siya because of the context, no? Bakit? Kasi hindi natin dapat sinasabi ang sayonara pag ganyan sinabi sa atin ng kasama natin. It should be, ano sasabihin? Siyempre, utskarisama deshita rin, di ba? Hindi naman natin pwede sabihin, arigato, di ba? Thank you yun. Ano, thank you. Okay. Kasi iba yung connotation pag utskarisama deshite, utskare, di ba? You're thanking them for the hard work. Arigato, sinasabi siya if you are, for other context, pero in this context kasi, workplace siya, mas appropriate yung word na utskarisama deshita. Okay. Pwede, sir, baka pwedeng sabihin na Jane or sore dewa or sore ja, bye. Pwede naman kaso you have pero hindi siya totally tama, no? Mas appropriate pa rin sabihin no otsukare sama deshita. Pwede niya siyang sabihin with conjunction otsukare sama deshita, so Jane babae. Pero syempre medyo less formal na siya kasi nga may Jane babae, 'di ba? So parang the safest answer here or the normal na sasabihin nila is otsukare sama deshita or otsukare sama. Okay, so that would be the ito yung medyo mahirap at medyo tricky because you have to identify kung tama ba siyang sinasabi natin. Okay? So, sa exam naman natin, konti lang ganitong part just to test you whether you are, the knowledge that you have gained is you can really apply that in real world. So, basically, naka-pattern kasi exam natin sa JPTL format din. Okay, so thank you very much and good luck. And ito pa pala. Meron pa pala. Sorry. Okay, meron pa. Okay. Another example is asking for whereabouts of Mr. Yamasaki. Yamasaki. Okay. Pardon me ha. Sorry. Dapat itong Zay ko. Okay. Kasi naging Zay siya eh. Dito is S. Okay. Zay siya. Okay. Dito S. Dito nakita. Okay. Yun pa. So that, may clue na kayo, no? Okay. Typographical. Okay. Kasi Z tapos S. Anyway, so asking for whereabouts of Mr. Yamasaki. Yamasaki, person A, sumimasen. Yamasaki-san wa dochira desu ka? So, based on the context, alam mo si person A, tama yung sinasabi niya. Excuse me, where is Mr. Yamasaki? Considering the Z and S issue or the kana issue, tama yung sinasabi ni person A. Now, for person B, hi, Daigaku Sensei desu. Para napaisip ka na malaki doon. Hi, Daigaku Sensei desu. Yes, Daigaku College Sensei desu. Teacher. Actually, kulang pa nga ng particle, no, di ba? So, parang Daigaku no Sensei desu. Pero pwede na rin yan. Kasi nga, baka isang noun siya, di ba? Okay, anyway, anong verdict ninyo? Mayroon bang kinalaman yung person, yung sinabi ni person B sa statement ng context ng conversation? Kung ang sagot nyo ay wala, hindi kayo nagkakamali. Parang wala talaga siyang connection. Kasi ang context is they're asking for the whereabouts of Mr. Yamasaki. Nasa si Mr. Yamasaki. Now, of course, yung sinabi ni person A na sumimasen, Yamasaki-san wa dochira desu ka? Where is Yamazaki-san? Nasaan siya? Kasi pwede niya sabihin doko, no? Pero siya, they use dochira. But okay din nun. Walang problema doon. Pero yung sagot ni person B, kakaiba, parang nasa ibang planeta siya. Ang sabi niya, yes, he is, or parang, yes, he is a college professor. So parang malayo yung sagot niya, di ba? So, for that, you will know that the statement ni person B wala sa context. Okay? So, yun po yung ating structure na exam. Okay? So, medyo mahirap lang itong functional culture context, pero for some, mahirap, no? For some, medyo madali sa kanila. Kasi, more of, ano yan, comprehension. Okay? So, that's it, I think. Yan, tama na. That's it na siya. Okay? So yeah, that's it. And I wish you good luck to your exam and of course study hard. And it will really kumbaga sa ano, it's just investment nyo kasi siya. So when you study foreign language and hopefully you can continue it up, marami kayong mararating sa buhay. It will be advantage on your part. Okay. So yun lang. So good luck and ingat tayo. For COVID, no? Bye-bye.